What's up, Guy Cosmo?
I fucked up big time.
What's up, Spaz?
Mario Party was ass. I thought everybody loves Mario Party.
Oh God, Butters, yeah, that went down. Which I feel bad because everybody cleared out when the Yoshi story started up.
Oh, IE6.
Yep. Him and Missy was the only two in there. Yeah, I saw Mirror's Edge. That was cool. I still gotta play that myself.
It's on Steam. What are you waiting for?
No, I bought it. I just didn't install it yet.
No. Well, what are you waiting for then?
I don't know. Same with Dark Souls. I ain't played that yet. Just sitting on my desktop doing nothing.
Gotta fix that. You gotta start playing these games. I started playing more Steam games now.
Esports. You know, it's funny you say that, Zach. I have Dota 2. Somebody gifted that to me. I forgot who.
Dota 2 is literally free, though.
Well,
people are like collecting Dota 2 passes for no reason at all. Collecting it like vintage porn. They serve no purpose at all.
Oh, yeah, you can go ahead and do it, Draco. I don't care. If you can find me, that is. Ha ha ha. No, I'm joking.
You're easy to find on Steam. For some reason, I'm like a challenge to find.
There. I don't make it hard for people to find me. You just ask.
I shouldn't be hard to find. There shouldn't be that many Burtons on Steam. Or say Burtons on Steam with a Sanai avatar. I mean, it's pretty obvious. Not only that, the description of my profile says like Toho plushie collector or something like that, which is another dead giveaway. Now I know there's not another Burton in the world with all of those. Just can't be.
No. Here's the thing, Draco. Negleria, start chatting it up with him about F-Zero. Instant favoritism right there.
Like who?
Negleria. Just like talking to him in general.
Yes, but who is he talking to?
Oh. They talking about his commentary for Mario Party and Draco Dan brought up like he's pretty cool.
Not everybody will agree with you on that.
Yeah, people got the opinions. That, you the one that brought the chest? Dude, everybody was all over that shit.
Oh, that chessboard?
Mm-hmm.
That was stupid. Didn't have a timer on it and people were trying to like speed run it or something?
Mm-hmm. Draco Dan, I had to, man. Like, you're just sitting right there. I'm like, dude, I can do this. I did it once before. Come on. Athens, you're right, man. I'm dead on Steam. You could add me if you want. I don't care.
I literally add anybody who sends me a request. Like, people add me, but they don't, like, do anything else after that. It's like some of them sent me like messages a couple of times, but it's literally add and just, I got Burton on Steam, what's up?
Yo, what's going on?
What's up? Burton started his month of cosplay.
He probably already knows that.
Yeah. I saw he was on when I rated DSS.
Okay, so you rated DSS and DSS rated me.
Uh-huh.
I see how it worked.
Mm-hmm. Because I knew he'd been on for a few hours, so I figured he was only going to be on for a bit more.
So I heard about your new route on Pokemon.
Uh-huh. So it makes it so much easier.
Like, I just went in there and I just saw you had a Raikou and wondered what the fuck was going on.
I mean, it's pretty cool, but the thing I really liked about the run that it was is that it was really, really difficult, and it's no longer really, really difficult, so I don't know. I'm happy that the time is a lot better, but as soon as I get a clean, resetless run, I'm just going to move on to the next game. Speaking of which, been looking into some Sonic shit. You know this full brainstorm?
Yeah, I've been watching him, like, break all these records and stuff. But I don't know if he's legit.
So do you know who the guy is?
No, nobody knows.
Okay, I'm pretty sure he's a bullshitter.
Yeah, I almost went, like, I wouldn't be surprised one bit.
Like, I'm about 90% sure. Like, I haven't been following too much, and I've just been looking at it for the past hour, but I'd imagine he's about 30% legit, 70% bullshit. I'm looking at some of the videos that he has for some records, and it's like, the videos that he'll put up are where he uses a trick that nobody else uses so he can get the record, but then you look at his playstyle, and it's absolute garbage. Like, he plays like shit, and I watched this one video, and like, his spin dash speed is more than double my spin dash speed, and my spin dash speed is not that great. So, yeah, he's pretty terrible, and like, just no general knowledge of how to go fast in the game. So I was like, nah, this guy's probably bullshit. Because, I mean, that's what you would do in that situation. Oh, I can get a free record. Let's make a video of this one. It'll prove I'm legit.
Yeah.
But, in fact, it does the opposite.
I don't know if he's ever been called out before or not.
And, like, he got this 0 points on Sonic R fucking quick.
Yeah.
And CD Championship. Like, the way he plays is terrible, so I really think he's bullshit.
Thing about it is you have to convince the mods somehow.
Uh-huh. Anyway. Gonna do some aisles tonight. Get back into my Sonic groove.
S3K?
Uh-huh. That's where I'm heading first. But might hit up some Advanced 3 later tonight. Yeah. You good?
Mm-hmm.
Also, SJ, you using a different mic, man?
No.
Oh.
If I sound different,
I don't know. I think he did have a different mic before, like, the last time you came in the call. It's been a while.
Oh, damn. Yeah,
you
did.
You remember, SJ?
You were
gone. He's been gone for a minute. Like, he had stuff to do.
Okay, yeah, in that case, yeah, I got a headset.
Oh, okay.
How could you forget?
Frokenok, what the hell? What's up?
I gotta get me another Game Boy Player disc.
Are you playing on emulator at the moment?
Yeah. I really don't want to either. But I don't want to stay off this game too long.
Yeah.
Also, I got another Sonic R PB today. 15-12.
Dang. Another 3 seconds?
Mm-hmm.
When are you gonna quit that game, son?
I don't know. I can... How low can I push this fucking game? Yeah, I think that's enough. I think I'll just move to any percent now. Cause I don't think anybody's touching that. At least anytime soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Daly's been like completely inactive with the game, so I definitely ain't gotta worry about him. Should do is kind of feeling like playing Shadow for some reason.
Uh-oh.
All these people finding me on Steam.
Sure know what. Oh shit. Yeah, Draco, blame Desi Dorada for that.
For what?
Beat Hazard.
What, the reason you have it?
Yeah.
Did he gift it to you?
Mm-hmm. It's pretty fun. Except, I probably gotta play some more.
You ever play Audio Surf?
No, and I heard of something else I should try. Pretty much games where you could use your own music.
Don't listen to the fools in here trying to get you to play Osu.
Man, not Osu.
It is Garbo.
Damn.
You don't like Osu?
Mm-mm. Mainly because Eshmon kept forcing it, and I got pissed off. So fuck Osu.
Damn. What the hell? Yeah. Okay.
Torch glitch time.
I've heard of that one, Wilbo.
Stay mad.
Now, you have to see that I'm not really a rhythm games kind of person. I never played Donkey Konga, but that's not really something I'd probably pick up anyway.
What about Jungle Beat?
Jungle Beat does look fun, but don't you gotta get those Kongos?
I don't know, I think you can play without them.
You have to I don't think you need them.
You can ask Hippie, I think he like messed around with it a little bit.
Damn, good old Brawl in the Family. No, Steve, I need more space on my hard drive. That's the problem. I would love to get more games. I just don't got no room.
Steve won't leave.
Yeah, I have an external, but this is my thing.
Mm-hmm.
I still need more room.
Man.
Delete all that porn, and you'll be fine.
Man.
Weren't you making room on your external anyway? Weren't you deleting a lot of stuff?
I reformatted it. So I got room on there now. It's just No. What was I doing? I'm trying to get a desktop this year anyway.
Oh, I see. I hate missing the first hit. Really dangerous boss right here.
Mike Rules, what do you think? Whatever you think, you're right.
All right, he's done. Now I'm gonna go over here and grab the angelic robe out of this chest. And if we get that far, you'll see what it's used for.
I sure do. Fucking desktops, man. It's fucking good. A good desktop.
So an i7, pretty much?
Pretty much. Unless they come out with like i9 or something.
I doubt it. Not anytime soon. Soon you'll be on board. You'll know how it feels. I'm telling you, that power, man. Do you even have room in your room for a desktop?
I'll make room.
Damn.
Man.
I know how you kept complaining about, like, I have no room in my house or something for this or that.
I really don't, but for real, I'll make room. Just have to do some rearranging and so.
No, I haven't tried Ephraim route on a run. It's a different category anyway, so there's really no need for me to tamper around with it right now if I choose to run that category.
Damn. You know what? I would love to build my own, so I could say I did. But I can see myself just being lazy and like, you know what? Fuck it. Pre-made. End up wasting more money.
Sounds like you.
Well, actually, yeah, Benjamin, I would like to do that. I would like to stream playing Steam games.
Damn. Missing everybody.
Okay, literally, who you say that, but I wasn't a Lego person growing up. I play with Kinects. Is it just as easy as those?
Mega Blocks?
Fucking Mega Blocks.
What? What's wrong with Mega Blocks? They're as good as Legos, right?
Oh my god. Snakes are harder. The hell? Always found them easy.
I mean, they all look similar. They all are different brands, but they had one thing in common. If you step on those things,
They get ghetto Legos. special needs.
No hate on my Mega Blocks, man.
One thing though, them Legos, when you was a kid, you lose them shits easily.
Fuck losing them. Leave them around the house so somebody steps on them.
Damn, that shit hurt. Oh no, cocoa butter. I'm not even in planning on doing this now. Like, this is probably like some months later.
Ever walk through a dark house and there's just a bunch of Legos on the floor? What the fuck do you do? And you're barefooted. No shoes.
I'm gonna bookmark this chip. Damn, Cherno, why are you so mean? Fuck. Gotta be dead. No, I still got my connects. I'm just mad because I broke one piece and I tried to get a replacement and it's like, what was it, like $5?
Fuck, man. This is terrible. I'm not supposed to be missing all these.
Thing is, though, I could buy that, like, right now and just build stuff, but I don't. Like, last thing I built was a Ferris wheel. There's probably spiders all up in it, too.
Wait.
I hope in case in years, huh?
You built a Ferris wheel?
Yeah.
Sounds awesome.
It was.
It's dead now, just like you and your stream.
Damn!
Glad you do it, SJ. You could have stopped this, SJ. All you had to do was stream.
Ago when those Ferris, not the Ferris wheel, but the roller coaster sets, those are dope. My friend in my old neighborhood, he had one. Man, we spent like a week or something on that shit.
And then somebody comes on and just kicks it over.
Wrecks it, man. I forgot how long he had it until somebody just destroyed it. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me?
There's always those people, man.
Damn, just see some nice shit. Just like, yeah, I'm gonna tear it up or something.
Just like when you're walking on the beach, you see somebody building a nice sandcastle and you wanna just kick it over.
God damn.
Like, you can't have that sandcastle. What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, the roller coaster worked. I think it used rubber bands to like go up the lift portion of it, but then after that it just went on its own.
Never made anything out of Legos?
Years ago, yeah. I made like custom bullshit. It was like, look at my big ass ship. Didn't look like no damn shit.
So you never had Mega Blocks before?
Nah, I didn't have Mega Blocks.
Ah. Didn't have the full Mega Block experience.
What's up, Don?
I did not want to do that. taking care of everybody just fine. As long as Tethys doesn't get killed. Because if she dies, I gotta reset.
Thing is, though, Kinex was more catered to, like, construction type. Well, not construction type. More like architectural type structures. You know, like buildings and shit like that. Whereas Legos was more versatile. I guess that's why they took off more than Kinex. So I was just thinking, why there's no, like, specialty shops for Kinex? Meanwhile, they got, like, Lego World and shit like that.
Is Kinex the one with the magnets?
No.
Oh, what's that? That's,
I forgot what
Oh, no, I know what Kinex... Oh, you're saying Kinex, as in K-N-E-X. Yeah. No, I had them as well. Along with Legos as well. But no, there was this one with magnets where you'd build shit.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I know about that one too.
There's like rods with metal ball magnets.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Chat, y'all know. What the fuck?
And then niggas be eating the balls.
Good. That's what I wanted to happen.
Wilbo, that is fantastic.
Let's get rid of these people first.
T-Man, you're right. Because that's some scary shit.
What is?
When you try to snap off a Kinex piece. Oh boy, what's this? Oh my god, a ghost building set. Ghost house building set. Based on Super Mario.
No strength for Seth. Another space for Torts Glitch. Whenever that skeleton guy moves in that space right there, I'll restart the game, and then when I come back, I get to control the enemy army. She'll move right after this guy. Right about now.
Oh my lord. Strawberry marshmallows? In case y'all don't check out my Ants.fm, base food porn guy.
Is he still at it?
Yeah. That don't make no damn sense.
Nothing too out of the ordinary about food porn. No, it's not an HDQ, Seth. Not even close. That's uncomparable. He actually gained about 3 or 4 strength levels, so that's good. Wow. Actually missed? What the fuck? Okay, this skeleton is not that fucking good at dodging. Damn. This fucking sucks. It's gonna waste a turn. Whoa, that's a good level up for him. Won't need it to be leveling up like that anyway. Still pretty neat to see it. I did not want to do that, just in case, because I've had it happen before. Just these guys left. Should be the last one. Yep. Thank you.
Oh, see you later, Draco. I will be back.
M0 GX is pretty cheap. When I bought it, it was only like $5.
Later, Luigi.
So much for leaving. This is a chapter where Saleh is going to be doing a lot of killing by himself. And since he's a sage, he has like no defense at all. He's going to be facing a lot of melee attackers. And that's why I gave him the elixir. The two biggest threats to him are the spiders, which have sharp claws, and they can do a major damage to him. What's up, Fear of Time? Are you still drunk? Also, see you later, Scarth. Okay, it's good, killed him. The dogs are really hard to hit, so they can be a pain to hit with Dazzler, since he's not the best of hitters. I actually live from two hand axes. Okay, he missed one. It isn't too bad. Can't expect to hit them all. Bring him over there to help him. So I don't like how that gargoyle's still there. You can double one of them. I'm not gonna play the guessing game with it. Alright. Oh yeah, don't worry about it. The main focus is trying to get a better run right now. Like, that's all done in the past. You don't have to worry about AGDQ anymore. Double criticals, I love it. Okay, I'm gonna use an elixir here. Just for safety. And since I'm sitting in the forest, I get plus 20 avoid, so... Spiders already have a hard time hitting anything, so... More than likely, they're gonna miss. Yep, and they both miss, so... We're all good. Damn! That level up! More of that, please.
Bet. 100% cranberry cherry.
Is that the one you got right now? Is that what you left for to get some ocean spray?
Mm-hmm. What else is in this? No, it's gotta be like a blend of like a whole bunch of shit.
Yeah. Gonna have to heal him this turn.
Yeah, blended with five juices. I don't know why they do that. But whatever.
One of them's gonna would have can't come over and tried to kill him if I didn't use that elixir. Alright, looks like all the poison, the enemies who can put poison on any of my units have died. Poison's just bad for the fact that it wastes a lot of time. For every turn, you have to sit there and wait about 5 seconds for each one.
Spaz, I forgot to do that shit at AGDQ.
Do what?
Spaz suggested I mix ocean spray with vodka.
And you had the chance. You had the ocean spray, but you didn't do it.
Damn it. And we don't got any here. Like, I don't know. I looked in my pantry. It's like 3 bottles of rum. I'm like, damn, I'm going to do with this.
Mix it with rum. Ocean spray?
Man. No, that's just how I drink, stay based.
Alright, we're out of here. Alright, I'm gonna go into the shop here and buy pure water.
Oh! Since you talked to Kirby Master, how come he wasn't there for a Fire Emblem?
He said he had an appointment to go to. He had, like, real life stuff going on or something.
Oh, okay.
Okay. This chapter right here can be a little troublesome sometimes. Depending on how good your set is. And I should be good to go.
Nah, I was gonna do that Di Serono with cranberry, but I hate fucking Di Serono.
Di Serono.
Yeah, never heard of that?
No.
Damn. Wait, you don't remember those commercials?
Mm-mm.
Damn, they used to be like all over TV. I wouldn't shut up about it.
I'm not gonna go for it this time. Usually I'll have Garrick sit there and be a backup to kill the boss, but I don't need to because I just remembered. Some bosses on some maps will be the first to attack you on their turn. So even if you don't beat them that turn, but they have a little bit of HP left, the very next turn they're gonna attack you first and they'll be gone. Okay. You know, Ballistas have to go after the weakest person, and Erica's the weakest one on the map right now. And just conveniently, on the last map, one of the gargoyles had a horse slayer. And the boss here just happens to be on a horse. But without this horse slayer, this boss would be pretty tough. He has some really, really good defense. So yeah, he won't take him out in one turn. So just like I said, next turn he's gonna attack Seth first. Oh, there's that strength up I needed. Wouldn't have killed the boss anyway.
Muttonhead, damn.
Muttonhead.
Don, I really don't know now. I really don't.
Alright, so here's the beginning of the most troublesome chapters. Starting with this one. And then, I've already said so many times, chapter 15. Let me make sure I have everybody out. Because this is one chapter I don't want to mess up. See, I already have the wrong people out. Okay.
Edible goat leaf.
Edible goat leaf.
Gold.
Oh.
Southern Comfort. I saw that get passed around. I didn't try it.
Oh, wait, no. Oh, fuck. I fucked up the formation. Oh, we're gonna have to just go with this then. Knew something was up.
Like, I'm not trying to be some hardcore connoisseur of liquors and such, but I do want to get a feel for like different types.
So yeah, this is all messed up. I fucked it up bad.
That's pretty good. It doesn't have that aftertaste like the other one does.
Which other one are you referring to?
The regular cranberry cherry. Also, like, I do try other brands of cranberry juice.
Really?
Never get no generic shit. Just don't.
Is it that bad?
It's ass. It's ass.
Damn.
Like, let's see. Old Orchard, that's good. What's that? Fuck, who makes that Simply stuff? Like, Simply Orange or Simply Lemonade?
Okay, the only bad thing about that is I usually use Rennick for a later chapter, but I have to do without him because I gotta improvise now.
Okay, I don't know who makes it, but Simply Cranberry, that's good. That's really good, actually.
You ever had Welch's Grape Juice?
Yes. That don't make no damn sense. That's like liquid grapes. Like, I don't know what the fuck they be doing.
But it's so good, ain't it?
Damn.
It's all that matters. It's good. I don't care if they put crack in there. It's good.
What the hell, Wilbo?
Ryan Cordell, what's the matter?
Yeah, Minute Maid is good too. Them and they crazy blends.
And I gotta take a door key. Equip the javelin rescue. Gotta wait another friggin' turn.
Damn, Zephyr Ryan. Fuck. Yeah, it is morning, ain't it? Damn. 6 a.m. Fuck, but it's the weekend. The weekend.
The weekend. What happened to weekend work?
I don't know. That was last year.
No more weekend work.
Nope. Boss, you changing my damn schedule. Smoke grapes. Nah.
Smoke grapes. How do you smoke a grape?
I'll tell you one stupid thing me and my friend did once. We snorted coffee grounds.
You snorted coffee grounds?
Yep.
That probably fucked you up too, didn't it?
Yeah, that was retarded. Retarded.
Did you think you were gonna get superpowers or something?
Nah, we was just stupid, that's all. I forgot what we were doing, honestly. I think we just came from, like, Sam's or something.
Did you sniff markers, too?
No, I ain't do that. Snorted Kool-Aid, fuck.
Cool? Why would you snort Kool-Aid? Oh, you mean a little, like, powder Kool-Aid before you... Damn. You should try that, SJ.
Mm-mm.
Snort all flavors of Kool-Aid.
Like, damn, like, fucking blue raspberry gives you the most high or something. I don't know. Pixie sticks, nah, man. Come on, I just did coffee grounds. Like, come on. I ain't go nuts. Dan? What's up, dude?
Alright, I'm getting so lucky on this boss lately. Thank you and good night.
What in the hell, John? You snorted maximum flavor. It's like overkill on your senses.
Dude, people will snort anything.
Do they make cranberry Kool-Aid? Let's find out.
Probably. They have a lot of more Kool-Aid flavors than you probably think.
I'm getting this roaring raspberry cranberry. That's probably as close as you'll get. I don't know about straight up cranberry Kool-Aid. Then again, they always had them, like, bullshit generic flavors, like orange. Nobody wants orange.
Orange is sort of a booty flavor, in my opinion.
Or lime.
Ugh.
Nobody buying it.
Got a problem with lime.
What the hell am I gonna do with lime?
Excalibur, go in. Ooh, there's a crit. Actually, that's supposed to be the other way around. Great job, me. For fucking up yet another formation. Oh, you ever, like, put Kool-Aid into, like, ice trays and then make some, like, ice homemade ice cubes?
Yes.
It's really cool.
At least once. Damn, they got, like, Kool-Aid sherbet. This, like, homemade stuff, now. Kool-Aid Jell-O. Some of this shit look good. What's this? What do you send your treats in? I'm not gonna send you my farts.
Fuck you, Tana, for being so fucking weak. Luckily, I don't need you after this fucking chapter. Both of you, Pegasus Knights. So I can deal with losing you.
Man, P, come on, man. Boil the fuck out of it. Dry it out or something. I don't know how this shit works. What's up, lobster?
Thank you. Been missing too many stuff. All right. All right. Starting with you.
This. I'll be back.
Whew. What's up, Boston Brew? Nice. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I think we're in some pretty good shape now. Yes, oh yes. That was perfect. Wipe them all out and like, the spear usually breaks before I wipe them all out. And before I could even use it all up. Perfect, just perfect. Couldn't ask for it any better. I just couldn't have. Still got jerk number one over here. No, why did I? God damn it. I'm just gonna go ahead and kill her. They can be kind of a menace. Since they don't attack back, have to waste turns killing them off. Damn, don't die now. Oh my god. Ooh! Oh my goodness gracious. He can double him. He is done. He has enough speed to double. That guy is finished. I don't care that he hit me. I can just heal up and he'll be dead the next turn. Like, there's just nothing he can do now. Shit, I'm gonna sit back. Garrick is almost fucking dead. I have to take care of Volter here. He'll be dead next turn. Of course. Alright, Noel. Give him all you got. Alright. Great job. You didn't get critical by his Luna, which usually happens. You know, just for safety, I gotta get them out of the way. Wait. Did I heal him? I don't think I did I? God damn. Watch, he's gonna hit. It's over, guys. I made the stupidest mistakes. They're gonna wait for him to be the last one. I fucked up bad. Oh wait, no, I did heal. Beat myself up over nothing. Why is he missing so much? His hit is not that bad on him. His hit was like 80 something, I'm pretty sure. So I have to get Ephraim to come up here and fight this guy. Oh, it's 78. Wow. Okay, either his skill was a lot lower than last time I came here or something. Terrible level up to go along with it. Yeah, both bosses are wiped out. This is going to be free. That makes my life a lot easier. Soon as Dazzle takes care of the rest of these Pegasus Knights. Noel isn't bad, it's just he has zero luck. And the guy who was about to attack him had Luna, and that has pretty good crit rate on it. I've had so many runs where Noel would just get critted by that guy and just die instantly. Thank God. Alright, since they actually count her as a flyer in this game, so the Philly Shield is actually a good idea to put on her. Plus the Hoplong Guard because of crits. She has terrible luck, and I've had her get crit by plenty of things. I can't even think of exactly. It's just not worth taking a chance on. No, that was right. Let's go. Okay. This chapter is usually easy, but anything can go wrong in this game. But I hope you like level ups, because there's going to be plenty of them in this chapter. Dragon Girl over here needs as many as she can get, so I'm gonna have her feed off of these guys. Hopefully I get those awesome speed gross like I did last. Whoa, shit, that was amazing. All right, that's a really good start. Keep that up, please. And they made it to where she can level up really easily in this game, so no matter who she kills, she's going to level up almost half of the time. Take care of this guy too. And right where I'm about to put Seth, if I move anybody up even one more space, everybody in that upper part of this map will attack. So I'm setting up so that Sage over to the left has a purge on him. So I'm setting it up to where I can easily go snag his stuff. And this turn, I will kill him. And I need purge for two chapters from here. For there. And there we go. And now they see her as like a very, very, very underleveled and very weak enemy. They don't really take bonuses from the Dragonstone into account when attacking her. So everybody on this map will try to attack her. Like, they just have no idea that they're gonna do zero damage no matter what. And that's a good thing. Well, except for him. He'll go after him because that's almost a guaranteed hit with bolting. And of course, he'll try to heal, but no reason to do that because he's going to die next turn anyway. Okay, I'm going to drop her off there. Wait, no. Get rid of this pesky mage. Kill off more of these guys, and next turn we'll take out Orson and leave this place. Come on, need some more speed. But yeah, pretty much, there's not many chapters that can, I guess, for sure ruin my run without me making some huge mistakes, even though I've made some in this run already. But nothing that was absolute killer. Alright, so this is what we do. Start out with the Lance Reaver because he has a spear. No crit, so it's perfectly fine. So we get her down here to possibly finish him off. And she misses. That's terrible. How much damage did he do? Yeah, I can't take that chance. So this doesn't happen too often. We're gonna have to sit here another turn. She had a 74 hit chance on him on that throne. But you know, 70s is really a shaky area for hits. Alright, he'll be dead next turn, no doubt. Okay, maybe. I keep forgetting those guys exist. Oh no, it's enough. What? Dude, no. Okay, thank God. How do you... Oh man, I don't even know. Let's just get out of here. And this is the part where you can get them to go into their better classes, but that wastes time. There's really no reason to do it, so we just skip that. And the next chapter is free as can be. There's no way you can lose. Just no way. Simple. You just have her do all the work. And this is another chapter where the boss will attack first if you happen to be in his attack range. So if I don't kill the boss this turn, he'll die next turn. And I don't know why that mage does that. Like, he doesn't even move. Alright, so this is another... This is another one of those times where he doesn't die, so... Next turn, he'll attack first and he'll be gone. Now you crit. Where was that? Another beast level up. They give you all of this stuff, and it's all useless to me. Maybe except for Vidofner. I actually use that. So, if Vidofner, if you're in here right now, you'll like that. Purge. Like, some of the things is just the last things on my mind. And Gorgon eggs give you 50 experience every time, so there's gonna be a lot of level ups in this chapter as well. If I put her positioning just right, too, you'll be able to see another version of the torch glitch, or the enemy control glitch, whichever you want to call it. Let's see. She's the only one who can carry him. Whoops. I did it early. Okay. So it pretty much works in the same form as the torch glitch. It's just those tiles where if they end their turn on it, it'll rise up and it'll take like 10 damage. If they wait on those, and when they black out, if you restart the game, just like the torch glitch, you'll be able to control the enemies. And all I really did here is take out the chance of them using stone on me, which is just absolutely disgusting to go against. So I just took that possibility out. So that makes this chapter much safer. And of course we get rid of that pest up there, that Shadow Shot, which is an extremely powerful magic. Actually, we'll just sit right here. No. Yeah. And this is also a good chapter for her, getting her level ups. 14 speed. If she gets enough speed, she'll be able to double a very, very tough boss coming up. Which just happens to be the chapter right before the end. Okay, that's horrible. That's very horrible. God damn it. Alright. I lost two fucking Pegasus Knights now. And I could have sworn that was at his fucking attack range, but it wasn't. I took a fucking chance. Whatever, though. The sucky thing is I actually sacrificed Cyrene in later on, so I'll have no Pegasus Knights for the final chapter. Like I said, I'm gonna try to finish this run. Why are they arguing about it? Like every other time I'm streaming, I hear about like there's some dumb argument going on in that thread. And of course, I have to wait till I stream to do it. I'll probably lose a little bit of time for obvious reasons. Fuck it. No. Guess I'm gonna have to use Colm instead, because Rennet got killed, or I had to kill him. Which I'm guessing shouldn't be too much of an issue. Alright, yet another torch glitch moment. The knight should be the first one to move. Right there. Alright, gonna move all these fools out of the way. And do a little neat thing right here. This is the boss right here. We're gonna take the enemies, rescue him, take another general, take him, and then drop him right there in the turn. And then these fools are gonna attack and do absolutely nothing but waste time. Alright, so we're gonna have Seth attack him. He probably won't die. That's what usually happens. And then she'll finish him off. And that's it. All this stuff I don't need. Oh, damn. The only time where L doesn't work. Alright, so this is the stupid chapter I kept talking about. Cyrene is all I got left. Let's see, so. Oh yeah, I have nobody to carry over Saleh. Guess I won't need him then. I just instantly thought of my other run. Guess I'm gonna have to do this the old fashioned way. So yeah, right there. She usually maxes out in this chapter, so she might hit level 20 here. There's 18 speed, so once again, she can double this boss. But man, I do not know what I'm gonna do for the final chapter. What I should do with Tana in the future is just dump all of her weapons, because she only gets doubled because she has that stupid heavy spear, and I don't know why keep it on her. It always causes trouble. Here these assholes come trying to cause trouble. Okay, from my video, I think it was that one right there. The one that's the bottom left of the Cyclops. He has like a spear or something, and he criticaled Erica, and it killed my run here. The bastard. So here goes nothing. She'll either give it to me or it's over. And if it goes the way it's supposed to, and it didn't last time, Reeve is supposed to be the last one to attack, which is the boss. Or, I don't even know if I should call him the boss at this level, but he has a shield over him. And if it goes that way... I didn't know he had a tomahawk. Oh, wow. Alright, that works. Yes, sorry, we're out. One more chapter. Oh, but I do not know what I'm gonna do for this one. I might have to use my older strat for this one, since I don't have any Pegasus Knights at all. Yeah, that's the only thing I can do. Either that or... I don't know. I don't know how having her solo would go. But we're about to find out. She only has 10 uses of her Dragonstone left, too. This is bad, 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 bad. Where's the pure water? Shit. Of course, I'm gonna have to get Seth up there somehow, so... Also, I don't care if my time sucks here. I just want to complete a run. That's what I'm at. That's the only thing I'm trying to do, to be honest. Just to make sure you guys actually know that. The important thing is trying to finish this run. That's why I'm so willing to keep this run alive. If I would have killed it like at the first Pegasus Knight dying, if it came down to it. But it shouldn't be too different. I said shouldn't be too different. Okay, the dragon missed. That's good, I guess. Also, what in the hell are these guys coming over here? They're testing me, man. Damn. That's right. And the dragon might go after Saleh, but at this point, I do not give a damn if he does. Oh. Worked in my favor. Cool. Okay, have him sit there. And at this point, I gotta use my javelins. Just move Solly out the way. Actually, I should have used her pure water at this point. Why do I keep forgetting important shit? Oh, it doesn't matter. They came over and blocked the way, which I was hoping wasn't gonna happen. What I can do now is... Damn. Please go. Alright, while Seth kills the rest of these guys off. Alright. But yeah, now you're fucked. Stepped in the wrong area with that shit. And one more. For good measure. Alright, next turn will be it. For exactly. I know why they keep trying to hit with Shadow Shot. Hurts a lot. Seth has no resistance for that kind of stuff. Alright, so what the plan was, I was gonna get a flyer to take Seth over here and have it to where we're in. Yes sir. Okay, this is it. Fuck it. We fucking won. Nothing can go wrong now. And they force animations, so enjoy this. Now please, critical. Nope, no crit. But doesn't matter, it's impossible to lose to this guy. That's it. That is it. Here's some hot Vidofner action. Whoever likes this weapon. Yeah, it's over. It's over. It is over. Because the next turn, he wastes a turn just summoning monsters. Like, what is this gonna do? Yeah, it's over. Yes. I believe in miracles now. The cosplay does it, man. Holy fuckles, dude. And stop. 139.04. Yes. We did it, Reddit. Whew. That's two runs in a day. Damn, dude. If this keeps going, like, for the rest of the, you know, the whole month of this happening, I could be down for this. But yeah, if you guys don't know, with all the new strats I put into the game, this is what I was talking about. This is why, at first, I had my estimate at 2 hours because of the time I got here, but you see... I still should ask for more time. But that's sort of kind of what the run looks like. Of course, there's a lot of places I can improve. Let's go for the sub 130 next time. Oh man, I cannot contain all this excitement. But now I want to see what it looks like when I don't screw up. Bashi 100%. You know what? Shadow Jackie was talking about playing Bashi. Like playing through Bashi at some point. I might jump on that train when he does. I don't know when it'll happen though. Whenever SJ jumps on Bashi, I may do it as well. I may. Keep it in mind, I may do it. But yeah, I'm gonna let the rest of this play out. Yeah, all my Pegasus Knight died. That chapter is supposed to be ended in 2 turns. But like I was saying, I didn't fully explain it. I get a Pegasus Knight to grab Seth, take him across that halfway point, drop him off there. You know, she can, Meyer or Mer, whatever her name is pronounced, she can fly herself over there. And you saw where I used the javelin on the white that was blocking the way to Lion. I just have him do that. So just deliver him over there, attack the guy blocking, have her going for the kill. And luckily for me, she got a critical. Sometimes that doesn't happen. The reason I get the pure water is to ensure that she doesn't die. And the reason I got the angelic robe is also for that part. Because even though she gets like a huge boost from the Dragonstone, it's still, he does still do a lot of damage to her. In fact, enough to where he will kill her on, you know, his turn coming up after I attack him. So if I use the pure water and have the angelic robe, he will not be able to kill her after that. So that pretty much ensured that she will kill him. That's why I said if I make it past chapter 19 or chapter 20, whichever chapter it was, then there's nothing that can stop me, because that's all it takes is to just pure water, go fight him, he's dead. And the final boss is just even easier, because mainly because he wastes a turn trying to summon monsters. But once you get, you know, past all of that, Meyer and Seth just destroy him. Yeah, Dan, if you want to count it that, yeah. like, believe it or not, whenever I'm settled, whatever time I get in this game, I'm not gonna do it immediately, but sometime in the future I'm gonna do stupid RNG set path. I probably won't stream that because that's mega boring, so I won't even bother, you know, doing that. But a game I've been holding off for far too long, and I was going to start playing, but AGDQ, you know, got in the way, was Path of Radiance. Like, I've been making routing videos and stuff like that, and I really need to get on that game. So whenever I'm done with this, I'm just gonna go ahead and jump to Path of Radiance, cause that game's overdue. I have to do it. Now, y'all are probably sick of Sacred Stones anyway. So I need to put this doggy down. So like I said, I want to go for sub 130 if it's possible, but we'll see how my green splits are looking after, you know, I do another run, which won't be today. Yes, Path of Radiance is the first GameCube Fire Emblem. It is the one that has Ike in it. But yes, I really need to move on to that game as soon as I can. But I don't want to, you know, fully neglect this game at the same time. Because I had all those deaths and stuff, I'm not really satisfied with this time. I want to say, if I get a run that has, like, no stupid deaths and stuff like that, I'll probably just stick with that. Go do Path of Radiance. Run the fuck out of that game. When I'm done, I may move to... I don't know if I'll move back to this. I may go ahead and move to Fire Emblem 7 after that, but we'll see. Right now, I'm worried about getting this done and getting on some Path of Radiance. Oh, Butters! I'm glad you can make it, man. See, this is what I was trying to make happen at the marathon. You see how much time I saved with all the new strats? I was just trying to see how much time it saved. Just couldn't make it happen. Sonic Triple Trouble. That's another game I gotta get on too. I'm still, you know, watching TSC because... You know who. She said, yeah, I'm gonna go back to STT and take it back at one day. And I'm sitting there every day looking, you know. That's the only reason I'm in Sonic Center, because I got STT on highlight. And I'm just waiting for Code Girl to announce that somebody took it. And I'm right back on it. Which, by the way, I still gotta download, what was it, Python or something for Shit Split. But I have to get Shit Split, you know, all in order before I start. And if you guys don't know, I also have this game on cart, if you guys know what this game is. But I never beat it yet, so I'm not even worried about runs of that game till I beat it. Shit Split is a tool that's pretty much like W Split, but made for real time. In-game timers like Sonic games. So just think W Split, but with a in-game timer. I think it was actually made for Sonic 2D Sonic runners, and since Triple Trouble is a 2D Sonic, I'll have to use that, you know, to get a more accurate PB. Because I did some joke runs here and there, but I used W-Split for that, and, you know, that's not completely accurate. Oh, Seth's made it. Okay, I didn't know who made it. Props to him then. I know who Seth is. Seth was the guy who was running Sonic CD 2011 for a bit until I guess Footbig Mike came in and just destroyed everything. Speaking of which, whenever I get my Sega CD working again, I'm gonna jump on some Sonic CD 93, not 2011. Get my plushies. I told you. Remilia's in arm's reach. I have to like reach all the way over there for the others. But you know, it's the same one from that I had during Worcester's run. Like Worcester was over there, you know, playing his game. And about like as farther as he got in the game, I just pulled out a plushie and just put it on the couch with me. But yeah, that is it.